Welcome to part 4. First, download the project file. In this file, we have a test animation applied to the bones, so you can jump to the skinning part. Also, we have a selection set of the bones we want to add to the skin modifier. Select the mesh, go to the modify panel and add a skin modifier to it. Set bone effect limit to 4 and enable show no envelopes under the display rollout. Now press add and use selection set to select all the bones. IK, FK and knob bones should not include in the selection set. Press play and yes, it needs lots of work. Our mesh is not high quality, so we mostly use vertex weighting. Hide everything except the body. Now we can easily paint or set vertex weight. Now I block out the bones. Make sure each of them is 100% affected by its closest bone. For the shoulder parts, I want them to look solid. For example, for this part, I will add spine tree, clav, and the neck bone. First, set a weight of 0 to a spine tree and set 0.5 to clav and neck. So we have two numbers that add up to 1. If I add 0.1 to a spine tree, we have two equal numbers for other bones. Because of this correct ratio we made, we can easily increase or decrease this number. If you add some other bones in the list, remove them by assigning 0 to them and pressing remove 0 weights under the advanced parameters rollout. After this step, we can blend them using paint weights or weight tool. Repeat this for the other parts of the creature. Skinning may take few days to complete, so patiently work on it. Thank you. use mirror parameters and press paste blue to green both.